Hello CI students, I am here again, your maths educator Shraddha Vaghani from Countryside International School. Are you all ready to learn with me? Sure then, let's start.
So students, our today's topic is rounding off of a number. Seeing the word rounding off, what comes to my mind is something or some object which is not round in shape is to be rounded off. Okay, let's take an example of say square, a rectangle, a kite or a rhombus. They are not circle in shape or round in shape, so you have to round it off. See, something which is not round in shape is to be rounded off. Let's take an example of rectangle. As you can see students, it is having corners. The corners is to be made smooth by rounding off. So it will come to be a circle. In our example, the corners are representing the exact values. When the exact value, that is the corners, are removed, the exact value will turn to be a rough value and the corners will turn to be a curved surface. This is just an imagination definition which comes to my mind. Maybe it will help you to remember what exactly the rounding off word means. Rounding off particularly is not the exact value of the number. It is nearer or closer value to the number, and hence you can easily recall it. And that's why we round off the exact value to a rough value. So the exact definition of a rounding off is actually close enough to the exact value. Now let's see what's the meaning of the sentence through the help of a digit or a number. The number is 17,437. We have to round it to the nearest 10. As the rounding off is to the nearest 10, that is, once in 1's place it is 7, in 10's place it is 3. So I'll draw a number line which will start from the number 17,430. As it is to the nearest 10's, no? So I'll start from 17,430 to 17,440. As you can see students, the number line is divided into 10 equal parts and each section is representing one unit. That is 17,430, then 17,431, 432, 433 and so on. Our number 17,437 is represented here as it is underlined here. See, you can see students that this number is more closer to 17,440 than to 17,430. So the answer to the question, that is rounding 17,437 to the nearest 10, will be 17,440. Are you getting students? See, suppose there is a person standing here. Let's take an example. It's a place A. There is a person standing here, say C. And there is a person standing here, say B. Now, B has to reach any of the person in the shortest time. So, where he'll go? Obviously, he'll go to the nearest person, that is C. Are you getting? So this number is closer to this number. Hence, the answer will be 17,440. Now, as you see students, we have increased the value of the number. It was 437. We have increased 3 points and made it to 17,440. So, these means I have rounded up. Clear? Now let's have the second example wherein I can explain you in more detail. Rounding off of the number 17,437 to the nearest 1,000. As it is 1,000, I will draw a number line which will start from 17,000 to 18,000. See students, here the number line is divided into 10 equal parts and each part is representing 100 unit. In the previous question, it was representing only 1 unit. In this question, it is representing 100 unit. That is, this line will represent 17,100, 17,200, 17,300, 400 and then 17,500. Our number is 17,437. Where will I represent this number in this number line? Yes, it will be represented near this number or in this section, that is here. Now tell me, this number is closer to 17,000 or it is closer to 18,000? It is clearly observed, no, it is closer to 17,000. So I'll round off 17,437 to the nearest 1,000, that is 17,000. See students, here the number is 17,437 and here the number is 17,000. We have decreased the number. Yes, from 437 we have come to 17,000 only. So this is an example of rounding down. We have rounded it down. Clear? See, conceptually I have taught you the number line system and you have understood that. But it would be difficult for you in the higher standards or when the number are greater in value, it would be difficult to round it off by using the number line system. So we have a new and easy way to do that. Let's have a look. Here I have taken a number that is 4,38,792. See, it's a larger number. Okay. And it is to be rounded off to the nearest 100. As it is to be rounded off to the nearest 100, which digit I am going to round it off in the number? 7, right? No, this is 1s, this is 10s, this is 100. So 7 is to be rounded off as it is to the nearest 100. So first of all, we'll represent this number in the place value. See, 7 is under 100s place, okay? Now, what the rule says is, if digit to the right of the rounding off place is 5 or more, we round up. We have seen in the previous example, we have rounded up and we have rounded down. When you round it up, when only the rounding off place, the digit to the right of the rounding off place is 5 or more. So, what is the rounding off place in our example? 7. This is the rounding off place. Observe properly, it is the digit to the right of the rounding off place. So what is the digit to the right of the rounding off place? It is 10s, that is 9 in our example. You have to see this digit. Don't make a mistake by seeing 7 only. See the digit to the right of the rounding off place, whether it is 5 or more. So 9 is greater or smaller than 5, it is greater. So it will be rounded up. 9 is greater than 5. So we will add 1 to the rounding off place. You are not going to add 1 to 9. You are going to add 1 to the rounding off place. Don't make mistake here also. So I'll change 7 into 8. That is adding 1 to the number. Now the number will change like this. It was 4,38,700. Now it is 4,38,800. Yeah. And then we are going to change all the remaining digits to 0. Here you have blank space, no? Now this remaining digit, you will place it with 0. This is how we deal with this. So the answer to my question is 438,792 to be rounded off to the nearest 100. My answer will be 438,800. Now you will cross check it. See, I have written the question here and rounding off the digit 100 here. As this is the rounding off place, that is 7. I have added 1 there and it turns to be 8. Why I have added 1? Because the digit to the right of the rounding off place, that is 9, is greater than 5. Clear with it? Moving on to the next question. Rounding off the same number to the nearest 1000. In the previous slide, we rounded it to the nearest 100. Now we are rounding off to the nearest 1000. See, this second rule, we'll see when the example comes. In the question, it is to be rounded off to the nearest 1000. So which is the number? Let's see. Place it into the place value system. 1000, no? Ones, tens, hundred, thousand. 8 is my rounding off place because it is to be rounded off to nearest 1000. The digit to the right of the rounding off place will be, the digit to the right of the rounding off place is more of, is 5 or more, we round it up. Okay. So, which is the digit here? It is 7. It is greater or smaller than 5? Yes, it is greater, no? As 7 is greater than 5, we will add 1 to the rounding off place. Remember students to add 1 to 8 and not to 7. This is the common mistake which all students do. So I am repeating it once again. I am adding 1 to 8. Now my number will be 439,000. I have changed this 8 into 9. Now our rule says the remaining or the rest of the digit we will place it with 0 and then change all the remaining digits to 0. So what will be my answer? 438,792 is rounded off by 1000 and the answer will be 439,000. See, I'm cross checking it. I'm writing it in the place value system. Then it is 1000. Now I'll add 1 to 8 because the digit to the right of the rounding off place, that is 8, is 7, which is greater than 5. So I'll add 1 to 8 and our answer will turn up to be 439,000. Clear, students? The next example. Rounding off the same number, that is 438,792, to the nearest tens. Now, as it is to be rounded off to the nearest tens, first find out the rounding off place, okay? By placing the number in the place value system. We have placed the number and in the rounding off place, that is in the tens place, ones and tens place, what is the number? It is 9. And our rule says that if the digit to the right of the rounding off place is 5 or more, we round up. That is, we'll add 1. And if the digit to the right of the rounding off place is 4 or less, we will round down. That is, we'll keep the digit as it is. In this example, you see students that the digit to the right of the rounding off place is 2. 2 is less than 5, yes? So, we will apply the second rule. That is, if it is less than 5, we will round down. Or we will keep the digit in the rounding off place as it is. See, you have to keep the digit to the rounding off place as it is. Or you have to add 1 to the rounding off place you have to add 1 to the rounding off place. See, the number will change now. 2 is less than 5. So we keep the rounding off place as it is. That is 9. The number is same. Now the rule says the rest of the digit is to be replaced by 0. So what's the answer? The answer to the question, rounding off 4,38,792 to the nearest tens will be 4,38,790. See, you have rounded down. It is not, the value was 92 here and the value has come down. It has not increased. It has come down to 90. So we have rounded down. Clear with it? I hope you are understanding and coming with me only. So our today's question is, tell me some examples from your real life wherein the rounding off is used. I have cited some examples here. You can think and add some new examples to the question. And just let me know by commenting in the YouTube channel. Thank you.